Deputy Inspector General of Police in charge of operations. AIG Zaki Mohammed. Zaki Ahmed, who is coordinating his operations and who is also speaking to you today. I welcome you all to the conference hall at Anambra State Police Command Headquarters. With us on this high table, on this side of the aisle, are AIG Dasuki Galadanchi, who is the AIG in charge of the counterterrorism unit. He's also on ground here for election duties. The host commissioner of police, CP Echeng Echeng. The commissioner of police in charge of Anambra State is also here with us. And then of course we have our colleague, a commissioner of police in charge of a neighboring state, the CP Delta State, CP Muhammad Ari. He is here with us. I am CP Frank Mba, the national spokesperson of the Nigeria Police Force. I want to very quickly tender our unreserved apologies to you all for starting well behind schedule. We planned this brief to be in two phases. The first one was to have an interactive session with the media, which we planned to start by 12:30 p.m., hoping that we would have been out of the peace signing at all. And thereafter, we will meet with our colleagues and brothers from the civil society organizations. Incidentally, things didn't work out the way we planned it. And for that reason, we are starting behind schedule. And then we seek your permission, your indulgence to merge the two meetings, considering the fact that it's essentially the same subject matter, and we are essentially working together to advance same goal and same purpose. Can we have the televisions turned off or their volumes turned completely down? We can turn them off completely. Turn the other side off as well. Just turn it off from the wall. I don't know whether it's going to be convenient, but I think that should be the best thing to do. Having told you the names of the persons on this side of the divide, if we can just run the mic very quickly so that we understand the people who are here.
Good afternoon. I wear four hats. One that you can see. The other one is I'm the founder and the CEO of the Abiru Foundation. The third one, I am the convener of Disability Inclusion Nigeria. And finally, I'm the president of the Albinism Association of Nigeria.
Can we stay on this? Stay here until we're done with this.
My name is Jake Ebele.
Good afternoon. My name is Faith Mwanji. I'm the executive director of Center for Transparency and Home Business, one of the accredited CSOs for the Anambra elections.
and the project coordinator of the European Center for Electoral Support here in Nigeria. Thank you for the invitation.
Good afternoon. My name is Philippe Sebregondi. I am the Vice President of the Electoral Support, the Center for Electoral Support. European Center for Electoral Support.
Yeah, good afternoon, all. My name is Sisi Akayaya. I work for European Center for Electoral Support.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm G. Wilson, Deputy Project Coordinator, European Center for Electoral Support.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Moses Oluwaseyi, Program Manager, Access Nigeria Campaign.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is McDonald Ekpebeze. I'm the Programs for Communications Manager, Center for Transparency and Governance at PG.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Paul James. I am the Program Manager, Yaga.
Good afternoon. My name is Dr. Akiche Onyedo. I work for Study Group Knowledge Change.
Good afternoon,
everybody. From the back.
Good afternoon, all. My name is Bami Delia Jai. I report for TV Cities.
Let me go. Andrew Gift is the name. I am with the BBC team here.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mike Israel. I represent the Defense Department.
My name is Swan Osikonu from the Nation Newspapers.
Isaiah and I'm so for the music yourself.
My name is
Innocent Aguara
from
PIT.
My name is
Chukwuma,
also from
the BBC. I'm Judah Tugwale, the editor of Fides. Good afternoon, everyone.
My name is
Tolu
Kampara from Pond.
My name is Vincent Juwan. I work for Bangladesh.
My name is Mike Dr.
My name is Alice Ennis from Nigeria
Police Radio. My name is Buzz Bujari. I write for the newspaper.
BBC.
Uche Ndeke, I report for Radio Nigeria. Chukwuma Ewu, AIT reporter.
And Emmanuel Tazia Intel. Mama, I report for Nigerian Police.
Kene Chukwuma, I want it to also be a report.
Good afternoon, my name is Peter Wally, coordinator network and good governance, observing for CTA.
I'm Divine Alex, in AFM.
I'm Lawrence Green, from London. Ikoye Wilson, Radio
99 from FM.
My name is Anambra,
I'm
the Deputy Project Coordinator
for Radio
Nigeria.
This is a very broad, comprehensive representation of not just the civil society group, but also the media. So I think we are very comfortable. This is just going to be a very short interaction. The IG was here yesterday and spoke extensively about what we intend to do. We've also been keeping you updated and we'll continue to keep you updated. But we essentially want to open up these channels of communication so that after today, you will most probably have the contacts of these officers on this side. I'll be able to reach them when there's need for you to reach any of us. And at this stage, I will pass the mic to my boss, DIG Zaki Ahmed, to actually speak to you. Just say this as purely an interaction forum, and we'll make it as brief as possible so that you can all return to your respective assignments. My boss, sir.
Thank you, the spokesperson of the Nigerian police. Good afternoon, everyone. I start by apologizing for starting this from this, but you all agree with me because most of you were there at the center attending the function. We apologize for that. We are here basically as the CPRO mentioned for an indirect session. You all know the purpose why we are here. It is for the purpose of gubernatorial election in Anambra State, which is coming up on the 6th of November, that is Saturday, in the next few days. I want to assure you all that we are going to maintain neutrality. We are going to provide a level playing ground for all political parties to participate in this election. And will be provided for those of you who have been in town for the cooperation with other security agencies to ensure that the election is adequately and take care of the situation. I would want to make available, or I would rather refer to the first PRO to provide our contact to all of you. If there is anything you can reach us, our doors are open. We would be alive to our responsibilities 24/7, so you can reach us at any time. I want to implore you, all of you, this is a national assignment. And we should all collaborate with one another. We should all work hand in hand. The objective is to have a peaceful, free and fair election where everyone will participate without any hindrance. I thank you most sincerely for being here, and we continue to interact from time to time, before, during, and after. Thank you very much for your attention.
Well, thank you, the DIG, and like I said earlier, it's just straight to the point. I think essentially we just want to get to meet you. We want to know those of you who are in our territory. We want you to know us. We want to deepen that synergy and create a seamless opportunity for us to be able to work together. In the course of this election, we will all have concerns about fake news. We appeal to you. Help us work with us so that we can all do appropriate fact checking, so that we can stem whatever news that is false, that is rearing its ugly head. We can work together to nip them in the bud before they go viral. So like my boss have said, before you step out of here, I'll give you the phone numbers of everyone on this table and even more. We'll also be providing you social media handles that you can send in messages to, numbers that you can reach out any time of the day. We will be receiving, those numbers will be dedicated to receiving complaints, but we don't just want to focus on complaints alone. Complaints about activities of policemen, complaints about activities of citizens. We will also be receiving commendations when necessary, please. Let us know where personnel so that they can also be encouraged. We will also be ready to hear your concerns. If you notice something trying to go wrong, please, rather than rush out to call us out, please reach out to us so that we can work together and take affirmative actions to deal with it. We want to be transparent, we're going to be accountable, and we're going to be responsive. Thank you. At this stage, we can take one or two questions and then go into networking.
Excuse me. Raised an alarm early in the morning that some elements in the police force, not known to the police hierarchy, had perfected plans to start arresting government officials to weaken their apartment. So I would like you to throw some light on this. Thank you.
Okay, now question and answer session now. During the press briefing by the police hierarchy for Anambra State, as the state they prepare for the election, the officers within in charge don't brief the press, and now questions don't they come in, and they try put their heads together to answer some of the questions where they don't raise. We include whether tomorrow they go get locked down or not, but the officers never give answer to that particular question, or would they wait for their response as they don't put their head together finish?
The response we are waiting. Yes, of course, it is the tradition whenever we have a national election with the street movement of people. This one is not going to be an isolation. On Friday, by 11:59, the restriction of movement will start. And it will, 11:59 p.m., or you can say 12 midnight. So the following day, Saturday, 11:59 p.m. So it is going to be a 24-hour restriction of movement. Thank you.
Yes, state government has said that some police people want to start arresting some of these.
There's an allegation from the state government that there are some members of the state, some state officials, targeted to be arrested by the police command,
elements in the police
to weaken their chances of winning the election.
No, that is fake news. There's nothing like that. Nobody has been arrested, and there's no plan to arrest anybody. I can give you this as well.
Okay, final one.
Sorry.
Actually, an observation I want to make. Most of all, our observers here stay in various success within our family. And I observed in the last 2 days that some of the tests will not find any presence of the police blanket. And I think we should, these are not just any out there,
You see,
sorry.
All the hotels are covered by police. Probably you have not seen physical presence of policemen in the hotel, maybe opening the gate and closing the gate. But all of them are policemen and are fully armed. They are ready to take care of any eventuality. And I also want you to observe one thing. All the streets where these hotels are located, there are patrols, there are men on duty on that street, if you can observe everywhere. So security is well fortified in all the hotels.
Please come this way, please.
The last question.
Please.
Okay, give civil society. Let civil society talk, please.
No, that question was
the last question.
That last one was.
One more to civil society.
Thank you again. My name again is NRB. Thank you, Commissioner. Two things I just want to stress. One is the welfare of the police forces. We are calling on the police force to ensure the welfare of the men that have been sent. This is very, very important because they're citizens as well. And so we worry about them. The other side is the issue of respect for human rights. I know that we are all proponents of respecting human rights. We are glad that you are here yourself, you know, Frank, that you are on the ground. And we are happy with the statement that came up, you know, from the DIG. But we want every citizen to go about. When we were coming in here, we don't know, we cannot know, so we cannot tell. We saw some young men lying down on the floor. They may have their own issues, we don't know what has been arrested, but we are calling for the respect of human rights while we're doing this, while this is going on. This evening, we are opening up Situation Room, and we are happy that we are going to have the numbers. If there is anything at all, we'll be able to share with you. For that respect, we call on them, and we are also calling on citizens to come out. Mass to be able to be part of it. I think one of the things is people are scared of going out because they say there is lockdown. What is the police doing maybe to counter that? That one can pronounce a lockdown. Election days are lockdown naturally. But for them to move around and ensure that their constitutional rights are there. I also want to say that you said when there is commendation we need to give that. I'm happy that this is negotiating. Since the city came in, negotiating with other people that may be agreed, so that we don't lock in, you know, people's grievances. Thank you very much.
The man with four cups.
Yes.
Thank you. My interest is my community, persons with disability. And understandably, I don't know how much the police know about issues with persons with disability, their priority rights to vote. How well have you prepared your men to understand that a person with disability, once he's at the polling unit, he's allowed to vote and go? And if your men don't have that information, the crowd may react. And if you don't have that information to inform the crowd or other voters that these people have a right to be given the first place to vote and go. And also you have a responsibility, maybe double responsibility, to give protection to persons with disability. How prepared are you to do that? Thank you.
Oh, really? Greetings. The name is Andrew Gift. I'm with the BBC team. I want you to kind of re-emphasize the number of the top hierarchy of police officers on this deployment. The IG had already said so, and so we've been deployed. Are you following what he has said? Are those people here? I've seen some, yes.
Secondly, there is a message, a voice note that's been going around the town telling hotel owners to leave, to let go of all the people that came to lodge in their hotels. But a group of journalists this morning were sent out of their hotel because of that voice note. The people threatened them, whosoever threatened them, possibly the people that threatens people. Now, what are you doing about this? I don't know if you're aware of the voice note one. What are you doing to ensure that people in the hotels, people that came in, mainly journalists and other observers, what are you doing to make sure that these people are safe? That should be my question. Thank you.
Yes, I think that let's be gender sensitive. I saw a lady raising her hand up. Maybe she has a contribution or a question. Okay, thank you very much.
Perfect.
That's the final question.
That's very important. For being very gender sensitive, I wouldn't let this pass. My name is Faith Machi, once again, and while I have the same concerns that colleagues in the room have, I'm also concerned about the deployment of the police to the polling units. From experience, last 4 years we were here in Anambra and other elections. Police have always said you will see at least 4 security personnel at polling units, but you get there and don't see that number at polling units. What is the assurance you're giving us, sir, that there's been proper deployment that has been made for us to have that? And also considering civil society organizations and observers who do roving, what's the assurance that we can move freely around on election day without being harassed? Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. I start with your question. Saturday is just 2 days away from today. And you will come here and confirm to me that the number of policemen posted in this election, I think that is higher than all the previous elections you have witnessed. You will give that confirmation here. So I can assure you that police and other security agencies will be in every polling station, and you will see it. All of you will see it. Then the other question about threat to hotels, I want you to disregard it. Every security measure has been put in place to ensure the security and safety of all. My friend with 4 cups, he just used 1 cup to ask a question. That is about the persons with disability. Persons with disability will be given priority to vote. And I can assure you their security is our concern. They will be adequately provided with the needed security. Then, a question about welfare of policemen. This is the first time in the history of elections where policemen are paid, are given allowances for their putting and other expenses before the D day of the election. So all policemen are catered to. The IG has worked so hard. We should commend him for the effort he made. The welfare of policemen is very dear to us, so all policemen are here. And then, with regards to respect for human rights, yes, we are doing our best, and we are equally going to continue to lecture our men to have respect for human rights, and you will see a change by the grace of Almighty. So once again, thank you very much for being here with us. May God Almighty continue to bless and protect you.
On behalf of the Deputy Inspector General of Police and Child Operations, and other very senior officers here on the site who want to thank you.
Now, Ron, here we'll go end the live broadcast for this particular press briefing by the hierarchy of police for Anambra State as the state they prepare for the election. As I talk to you now, they don't detail how they plan to make sure citizens secure life and property during the election and to ensure that peace day and that nobody will be intimidated. They say they go make sure citizens protect human rights and they will give out their numbers so that if anybody run into any wahala, they go fit looking to them immediately. And the hello, all of now don't join us for the broadcast. All of now don't join us. We still let you know. Say as time they go on, we go still they bring with other updates of things where they happen live and direct. Live and direct. The things will happen live and direct for Anambra State as the election they happen. We greet all of us and want to join us for this broadcast on a well done.